was not a criminal nor a civil.
Because it was what?
Because it was neither a criminal or civil charge.
Okay, what charge was it?
Allegedly speeding.
Okay, it's based on a contract.
Contract with you, I don't live in that state.
It's, okay, you have a contract, and the contract is, they call now in the United States is, every driver's license is recognized as a bona fide legitimate,
yeah,
like a marriage.
It's called a compact agreement, it's illegal as fuck.
Dude, okay, it's like a marriage license, okay? It's like black people used to not be able to be recognized being married to white people in certain states in this country. It didn't matter. That you could legally marry
one state. It's a commercial license.
That's right.
If I'm not engaged in commerce, it does not apply.
What doesn't apply?
The fact that I have a license in my pocket. If I'm not transferring property of passengers upon the highways for compensation, I don't need a fucking driver's license.
I didn't say you needed one. You said that you got a ticket in Mississippi, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so what did you do once you got that ticket?
I called the county courthouse and asked them if it was civil or criminal. They said neither.
I said, okay,
may I have the number of the prosecutor's office? They said, well, you got to enter a plea. I said, well, how do you expect me to enter a plea when I don't know the nature and the cause of the proceeding?
I said, okay, I plead insanity. Okay, great. Now, give me the name of the prosecutor. The lady said that you had to enter a plea. What did you do next?
I said, I plead insanity. She said, we don't accept that.
Okay, so you don't accept the insanity. What did you do next?
I called the prosecutor.
Okay, why did you call the prosecutor if you called the clerk and you were trying to find out who the prosecutor was?
Because there's no name on the citation.
How did you find the prosecutor's name? The clerk wouldn't give it to you.
The clerk did give it to me after I told her I was going to plead insanity.
Okay, but then she did give it to you. Okay, great. So now you just told him, you know, whatever the hell that was all about. You got the name of the prosecutor. Great.
Uh-huh.
Now, what did you, when you got the name of the prosecutor, then what did you do?
I said, Mr. Prosecutor, I'd like to know where I could send my requirement for discovery. He said, you a lawyer? I said, I was never. He said,
okay,
well, we don't have any discovery here. I said, oh,
that's
really?
Right. Discover what? What did you want to discover?
I said I wanted to discover the facts of the case.
You want to discover what?
The facts of the case. I wanted to know.
The facts of the case is that you were doing 9,000 miles an hour on a unicorn cycle going backwards on your roof. Yeah, there's your facts.
Where's your proof?
Dude, because I don't care what the facts are and I don't care what the evidence is. Facts and evidence means nothing in a common law court. The only thing I care about is the injured party. I don't care what your facts are. I don't care what your evidence is. I don't care if you said I was going 900 miles an hour on a unicorn cycle, in reverse, zigzagging all over the road, crossing 300 yellow lines. I don't give a damn.